two operating systems. Not only two, there are some other operating systems, two are there. So for you to understand, and those who are not aware of to use these things, I suggest from now onwards, you can maintain a Windows operating system. If you have a laptop, it keep it like that only, there is no wrong. And you can install either VMware. There are two types of virtual box managers. One is called VMware, another is Oracle Virtual Machine. So I prefer Oracle Virtual Machine. It's very easy to install. So these are all open source. These are all free softwares. No need to purchase anything, please. So you first you install Oracle Virtual Machine. It's very easy, which can run on your Windows operating system. So once Oracle Virtual Machine is installed, you can install whatever the other operating systems. You can go for Ubuntu. You can go for even the other Red Hat Linux, other SCO Unix. So there are other operating systems and other application tools you can easily install here, and you can practice them. So here, Ubuntu 18 is there here in one of them. So I do practice my programming and other application developments using this. So you can issue your Unix commands here, and it goes on. So there are so many things here. So that's why I prefer for Unix. So in the same way, for all of you, just take some to install Unix operating system on the virtual machine. You first install the virtual box. Once you install your virtual box, you can download the Unix operating system from the Ubuntu website itself. So Ubuntu, you can see the latest version of Ubuntu 20.04, LTS, long-term evaluation is there. So here you can download this version of this, any whatever the, if you want to go for server, you can go for this. If you want to go for simply desktop, you can go for desktop. So like this, once you download onto your virtual machine and install, it will be next, and it will be completed in at the maximum 15 to 20 minutes, not more than 20 minutes. So you can install your Unix operating system here on your virtual box. Now, once you install, let us see now regarding to the assignment one. I'm talking about the assignment one here, please. Let me minimize my screens. Even Oracle Virtual Machine, you can also download from your internet itself. Oracle VirtualBox step-by-step download is option is available. So you can go to the corresponding website, downloads Oracle Virtual Machine VirtualBox. So for Windows host, because I'm running my Windows operating system, we have to choose Windows host. So once you download it and install it, after that, you can install your Unix operating system. Once you install that, your machine looks like this. So of course, there are other operating systems to install. If you install as many operating systems, you can use. The advantage of here is, if you make any mistake here, in this virtual box, if you write some commands and you are having some problems with your machines, no problem. Your machine will not go wrong at all. Only thing is your virtual box, this particular software gets crashed and your operating system of your host system does not change anything. So you are safe with this. You are safe with your existing applications, existing your programs, your laptop operating systems, everything will remain intact. They will not get changed. If you make any mistakes in this virtual box, only this virtual box gets crashed and you can simply recover it. There's no problem here. So you can practice here. You can play like anything. So that is the advantage of having virtual boxes. So I prefer these virtual boxes. Nowadays, so much of application development, people, when they start deploying it, before deploying to the actual environment, they do programming on the virtual boxes and they come back to the normal systems. So for networking concepts, for web applications, these virtual box machines are very much useful. So I hope you have understood it. If you're not understood, you can send me the emails or you can ask me now also. There is no problem. I'll try to answer it, whatever the questions you have it. So you can maintain two operating systems on your same computer. So one is on the Windows, the other is on the Ubuntu. that is your Linux flavor. Now coming to the assignment question. So there won't be any problems with respect to the bind software now, because already the bind software is for Windows platforms. Now when you are working on this Unix platforms, see now your dig command is going to be run here properly. Yeah, I'm running the DNS internet grover command dig. So I'm able to run and I can see. So now regarding to the assignment questions, I'm just coming to that. So there is no question of having the installation of additional softwares on the Linux. So Linux has got an advantage here. And some, of course, for a student, there are some commands are there, Linux command, and you need to get used to it. Now only this is the exact time and this is the right time for you to get practice and get the awareness and also the knowledge and the skills on how to use your Unix machines. So far you might not use the Windows. Sometimes in interviews people do ask questions whether you're aware of this Unix machine programming, any kind of, even you can write Python programs, even our PHP, MySQL, Apache. Of course I'm going to install that LAMP stacks on this Unix and I'll show you. Means later programming and most of the things will be running on these machines only, on the virtual machine. So this is the right time for you to install your Unix machine if you are having Windows operating system on your laptop. So you should not depend on additional softwares. If you want additional softwares, you can install here on the Unix. It will be very easy to install. Now coming to this question, just hold on. Regarding to the assignment, just I'm opening the screen. So here, just I'm giving hints only. I'm not giving the answers for this assignment because the those who are running on the Windows, I have given the steps. So those are having problems with respect to the bind. If you are able to install it, well, it's good. If you are unable to install it, then I told one of the student has actually asked for Microsoft Visual Studio runtime environment was required to install this bind and that is not supporting. That's what it's creating errors. That's what I think Arun Dharawat has been asking. So I just suggested him try to look for that proper troubleshooting. If you want to avoid all those troubleshootings, you always prefer for Unix environments. Unix environments, things will run very comfortably once you install here. So that will also be useful for you because you'll be playing in the Unix environment. Now, I think by this time you might have understood what is single A indicates. Single A indicates the IPv4. And the four capital A's indicates the IPv6. So you know the difference between IPv4 and IPv6, not only in the number of bits, even the addresses you have to look for carefully. So address structure, I think you have seen in the TCP/IP. What is that address structure and all? Let me just zoom it so that I'll just show you some of the commands which are already executed on the Unix environment. So here, I already shown you two commands here, dig google.com/any. One student has asked whether we can change the any, one of the girl student. So here, see dig, when I show you the example and it's showing me the output, it means that a command is running successfully. So please do not change the orders anything, because if you might have made some mistakes on the Windows environment, something, some error may be there, because I cannot exactly say what error is, because Windows has got a lot of issues will be there when you're running some commands. So here, which I run here, it clearly shows you that this is commands which I run on the Unix. So if I run the same command again, you see it on my screen now. So dig, D-I-G, dig. google.com/any. is one of the options of the dig command. So it is giving, see, some information is coming here. So the IP address is 172.217.160.144. It is a IPv4 address. Clearly, it shows capital A. Capital A address is 172. The 4 A's, this is IPv6. The IPv6 are this particular value. And the Google web server, it is getting connected to ns3.google.com. So the root server, what is the root server? What is the root servers and all the information I given in the lecture. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me now. So regarding to that answer for that question, for the any option, you can see the answer is coming here. So you please try to get from, when you run on your system, this addresses may change. Some may get NS3, some may get NS2, some may get NS1, some may get NS4. So these answers, you may get different thing, depends on your internet service provider. That's why don't give your answers to your friends. It will definitely go wrong. We can trace it back and check it whether you're run on your system or not. So please be careful when you're giving the answers of other students. Not only for this lab, for other labs too. Coming labs are most important for you. So this is the two questions which are related to the bind and as well as to the any. There's another question actually. The question is for one of the student regarding to, let me open that question here. Tarun's question is that this information about mail user agent is discussed in SMTP protocol in the textbook, but it is given in the quiz 3. Yes, some questions maybe it's not that exactly related to that particular chapter. So you need to be thorough. And I could see that in quiz 3 also, some of them have got almost 10 to 10. Of course, they might have searched on the internet and got the answer. I'm not telling like that. But people are able to solve it. So it is not that out of the syllabus for that particular topic. So please be aware of that things. One or two questions will be related, because please, if you observe my video lecture, in my video, I clearly told about that SMTP is the software which has been used in the mail exchange server. So that question is related to that. Listen to the audio, then you will get back the answer properly. And regarding the quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3, I think many of you are there now, almost around 50 plus, yeah, 52 are there. So I would like to just say something. We already taken the backup of your answers for week 1, quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3. The marks which you have obtained on those things, we have taken. But our worry is basically on the people who have not attempted it. Of course, one student has taken the permission. Apart from one student, so you can see the red color marks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 students have not attempted at all. Out of 82 students, 7 students have not attempted the quiz, and 1 already responded today. So the remaining 6 students, among the 6, again, 1 has attempted quiz 1, but not quiz 2 and quiz 3. So it comes to 5 students who has not attempted any quiz. So please, among the 5, I think this student itself is not registered. So it comes down to 4 students. So because some students are having some health issues and some internet connectivity problems, so what we have discussed and we have made some updates regarding the submissions of your quizzes, so we have extended to 1 more week because some students are having problems related to health as well as the internet connectivity issues. So we will give 2 weeks time from now onwards for all the quizzes. So I think, is it acceptable?
I have a suggestion here for all the students. Okay. So here we are giving 2 weeks extension, 2 weeks time for solving all the quizzes. Okay. Because like some students have some issues, but don't take this chance. Okay. Until and unless like you finish the quiz of the last week, you will not be able to understand the material of this week. So if you take the chance, whatever we are giving of 2 weeks for the submission of quizzes, literally, you will always fall behind in terms of the topics and in terms of leveling. So we strongly encourage all of you to finish by end of the week. But then considering the internet issues and also like some health issues for some of the students and so on and so, in future, like we will always be giving 2 weeks for this sort of quiz submissions. okay? But we strongly encourage you to finish it in within 1 week. Agree?
Yes, screen recording is off. I do not get it actually, because the recording is on only. I hope you are able to see my screens properly, right?
Yeah, Nagender, it was that question which I actually told you, like, now we should.
Okay.
So nobody has responded after that.
Yeah, but okay. So now recording is there. So even the absentees of this session can also see what we are planning. So please, I suggest you please go through the installing the virtual machine and installing those operating system which you like to have it, either Ubuntu or your Linux. Then you can run your commands properly. And coming to the assignment two, that's what you have seen in the week two. What we have done is we have discussed some more protocols like FTP, SSH, HTTP. We can also install one software from Microsoft Store for using the. See, one second, please don't get confused. See, we are not using dic command. This dic command is not a very big thing. Only thing is, what I'm suggesting is one of the commands for DNS servers. So you need to just get an awareness of this one. So you can simply use it. You can also install Ubuntu software from Microsoft Store. Oh, yes, you can install Ubuntu software from Microsoft Store if the Microsoft Store is providing you to download it. Or you can download directly from the Ubuntu website itself. So there is no issues. Because I installed so many operating systems at so many occasions, you can directly install from the Ubuntu website. You can go for 16 will be outdated soon, so you can prefer for 18 and 20 Ubuntu latest versions. Right, now coming to assignment two. So the assignment two, we have planned something around HTTP. So HTTP is also some commands will be there using curl command. Of course, those commands which you are not discussed in the video lessons nor in the slides, that things will be given as an assignment here. So don't think they are not discussed. So we expect you to explore more along with the slides, along with the material. And what are the questions we give it in the assignment? There will be some information where you can get more information about that assignment. So we want you to engage and we want you to please go through the materials properly, understand them. If you are not clear, please ask us. Then we will try to help you so that it is a continuous process. And don't expect everything will be done in 1 or 2 weeks. So it's not a slow process. You have to go in a steady process. So that's the thing. So assignment two will be on HTTP. That we'll post it today evening after the session is over. Tonight we'll post the assignment two. And you have seen that quiz 4, quiz 5, quiz 6 is also given to you. So please go through the video lessons, the materials, and assignment. You can submit it. And do not wait for the last minute. Still, I'm observing that quiz 3 is submitted only just yesterday, many of you. So that as sir suggested, as and when you can is possible from your side, please complete. It is a 20-20 minutes video lesson. You're not giving 1 hour lectures. So it's just a 20-20 minutes. Very happily and very joyfully you can see simply those. Of course, the lectures may be a little bit boring, but please put your heart into that. Definitely you'll understand it. And if you cannot understand, then please ask us. Then we'll try to rectify as much as we can.
Nagender, one additional thing for the recording, okay?
Yeah.
Because like in the beginning, like we were not recording. For the students who may view this video later, so we also have discussed thoroughly about Base64 encoding and the padding of Base64 encoding. So for the people, if you have any further doubts on Base64 encoding, this Wikipedia page is excellent for that one. So in the beginning of the lecture, we have discussed about this Base64 encoding and how to Base64 encode each and every word as well in detail. But reading this Wikipedia page itself is sufficient for you to understand in detail. Thank you. So now we are open for any further questions if you have, okay? Either about week one or week two material.
Yeah, I'll come back to the lab practicals for integrated MTech. Kindly hold on. I'm just waiting for some more students to join for integrated MTech. We are starting the practicals from this week onwards. I will tell the procedures and how do you go about it. So kindly hold on. For MCS students, because the last week I was waiting for the responses from you all to give whether you are having laptop and internet Only 16 students have responded, including integrated MTech and MCS students. So I presume that you have all your laptops with you and you can install the softwares. So with that assumption, I'm going forward because I waited. So only 16 of them have responded to my emails, missed my request. So I presume that you can install the softwares and you can run it. If you cannot run it, there are other alternatives are there in the sense if you don't have a laptop. So do not worry about your laptop configurations. So even a 1 GB RAM laptop is sufficient for you to run the programs. Only for some Ruby software, you need to have at least 2 GB of RAM for the installation of the software. Other than that, nothing. All your minimum 1 or 2 GB laptops with processor. Of course, I hope at least the laptop which you purchased 2-3 years back also will be sufficient. You need not purchase a new device. Even if you cannot have a laptop, you can run these programs on the internet. Even if you cannot run on the internet, we will provide you the login IDs which you can run on the Moodle. So these are the alternatives for us. If you can access the Moodle website, then you can run your programs too. Because already the C programs are run by some of our faculties. They are running it properly for their student lab exercises. So this Moodle supports your Python programs, your JavaScript programs, and the other set of programs can be easily run on this Moodle too. So these are the other alternatives what I suggested. If you can access through mobile, yes, last time H5P that has enabled on the immediate day. So I hope H5P videos are now being played on the mobile too. There was one option was not set in the administration of that website. So I have set it now. So I was able to now play that H5P video on my mobile. Now it is playing. So I hope the other students can able to play those videos. Right now, just hold on for another 5 to 10 minutes. I'll come back to the practicals. In meantime, please go through that materials or any other doubts. You can put forward those doubts. You can as well speak using your mic, please. No problem. If all people are speaking, then that will be a problem for us. So if anybody wants to speak over mic, you are welcome. There's no problem. Just have a practice of even talking directly like this. So we do encourage this. It's not that only you are chatting, you have to post. So we are all one together only. So don't worry about, don't feel shy also. You have to put some questions. Even if it is silly, do not worry. It doesn't mean that you don't have doubts. You can leave the sessions, please. I hope you are going through the material and you are waiting for some questions. Because from, yes, this is just a beginning. Next week onwards, material will be a little bit lengthy and more contents will be there. So this is the first 2 weeks we go with very slowly. So the it's not that we are bombarding you with a lot of information, a lot of contents with slides and videos. We want you to be regular in reading those materials, understanding them and moving forward. Imran Khan is there now. Imran, can you please respond, Imran? Imran? Lakmalanji, can you please respond, Lakmalanji?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how are you?
Fine, sir.
Yeah, so have you started reading, at least reading the material and seeing the videos?
Yeah, sir.
But I could see that your log activity, you have not seen some of the videos.
Yeah,
so... Please do not worry, and you start asking the questions from your side, whatever the doubts, even it is SP also, do not worry. You can ask, see, you can send the emails wherever you will have some doubts. Sometimes we immediately respond to you, sometimes you may come back to either Monday or Friday discussions. So don't worry about those. We will definitely get back. Even if you missed it, please you raise the question again, either in this platform or some other platform. So Lakmalanji, I request you to please go through it. Okay. Yeah. So okay. Imran, Imran, I could also see you are not done any activity, quiz activities. Imran Khan, yeah, you have responded. Thank you. So can you please respond? Yeah. Yeah, I think some problem with your problem at your side with the audio. So actually, I could from the Excel sheet what I downloaded. So there is a you are not made an attempt for this one. So quiz one, quiz two, quiz three, you are not made an attempt. I think you can see my screen. Are you able to see my screen? Oh, sorry, just hold on. Okay, Imran, no problem. Please type, you can do the text chatting. So what I am just asking, I'm a little bit curious, is there any problem regarding this attempt, making an attempt to solve some of the questions in this quiz one, quiz two, quiz three? Because you're not made an attempt at all. If you don't mind, can you just say what is the reason for that? On the text chat, you can just mention it if you don't mind. If not now, please later you please try to respond. Yeah, so regarding the lab sessions, so we are starting from this week onwards, the lab sessions. So because for MCA students, officially there is no lab component. It means there is no lab test for you, there is no lab exams, nor lab exercises. But what we suggest you is you can practice whatever the exercises we are giving to the integrated MTech students. Every week there will be lab exercises too. So those will be something like an assignment, and that assignment is given for both of you. But for integrated MTech, we are going to evaluate and we are going to see, and we are, you can see those lab exercises on for integrated MTech students. The lab exercises will be put on this particular course page, Internet Technologies Lab. So there will be regarding to the lab announcements and those exercises, the topics, the week wise, along with the, some explanations of the programs, everything is goes on in this particular course page. With respect to the MCS students, whatever the assignments that we give it, assignments in the sense the lab assignments and the weekly assignments that we give it for the IMTech students, those assignments are also going to be posted on our course page. So our course page for MCS students, you can see it on the course page here. So you can see we'll put some another topic here on the under the topic, we'll keep the lab assignments. So that lab assignments, that is optional for MCS students. It is not going to be considered for evaluation, only for evaluation. But we suggest you to practice those assignments weekly and do not pen all those works. Don't do those exercises at the end of the semester or at the mid exams. So every week, along with this quizzes, you will be having the weekly lab assignments too. But those assignments will be not counted for evaluation. For integrated MTech students, yes, those evaluations will be counted, and that will be counted. The assessment will be considered for lab component. Is it acceptable for MCS students? Am I audible to you, please? This is the biggest problem now.
You're audible.
Yes, sir. So, MCS students, what we suggest you is to, we'll also put the lab assignments questions, the same questions what we are going to give it for the integrated MTech students. So, those questions, yeah. So, please do practice from this week onwards, means from Wednesday onwards, you will see those questions here. For integrated MTech students, so every week there will be questions that will be there. So, you please practice and you need to submit those assignments accordingly. Yeah, now I get the responses from MCO. Okay, fine. That should be fine. So, we start those practicals from we started using dig command, and this assignment two will be related to HTTP. That is also a small exercise. How do you get your using the get command and using the curl command, how do you get your HTML page contents and store it locally? Some 4 to 5 exercise questions will be there related to HTTP protocol, because HTTP is a very important protocol. Everybody should understand what is HTTP protocol and what does it do. So that is the assignment two. That is a common for integrated MTech and MCS students. But from next week onwards, we start unit two. Unit two is starting the web technologies, that is your internet technologies more specifically. Your starts with HTML, CSS, document object modeling, DOM, followed by JavaScript, PHP. So that is all unit two is completely practicals. Everything is on practice. So 90% of them will be practice, only 10 to 15% will be around theory. So from that particular week onwards, coming Monday onwards, before that only we'll put the material and this for the lab practicals, so the material and the exercises. So we keep monitoring those exercises for integrated MTech students for evaluation purpose. So there's an evaluation purpose. So that theory as well as the material for that will be posted anyway in the course pages. But for the lab components, separate exercises will be there that will be evaluated for integrated MTech students for the semester assessments. Whereas for IMCS, if you can submit, yes, you can submit it. But it is always better, because we don't want to leave it like that for you, since it is not an evaluation component for you. So if you are submitting, if you accept, then we'll consider as an assignment for you. So that I would like to know from you only. So the lab exercises that what we give for integrated students, because they are going to give they are going to submit it, that will be evaluated for their assessment procedure. If you can submit it weekly, or once in 2 weeks you can submit those lab exercises. If you submit, then we can consider it for assignments. Do you accept for that? If you prefer for that, then please let us know. If you are not, nobody is responding, then we assume that you prefer for it, please. If you are having some objection, please raise the objection. That will be better then. Because we want to get confirmation from you only. Until unless you don't get confirmation, we don't want to impose something on you.
Okay. So we strongly encourage you to do the assignments as well. I mean, like even the lab components as well. You will learn more. But of course, from your curriculum point of view, it is not compulsory for you. So Nagendra is actually trying to put you into a corner, okay? So you all have to agree or disagree. So he is trying to make you talk.
Yeah, please, let us have a discussion at least. And if not now, please send us the mail at least. If you cannot openly say something, that's what I last week I was asking for the CR, class representative for MCA students. Nobody is even coming forward to coordinate with your friends, please. Just hold on, then I will just find out. 1 second. So in meantime, please go through the materials. If there are any doubts, please let us know. Amandeep is there? Is he present in today's session, Amandeep? MCA student Amandeep? No. Vani Gupta? No. Okay, if anyone can meet your class representative, if he is not present in this today's session, please inform him about our plan of action for that assignments. So the lab exercises that we give it every week will be considered as an assignments for you, so that you can work it on it and you can submit weekly the assignments. And basically those assignments are the lab exercises of integrated MTech students. So if you are agreeing to this one, then we will consider those as an assignments for you, because we don't want to give more works and more pressurize you with a lot of again additional assignments and lab exercises and quizzes. So many things will be added up on you, so we don't want to give much workload to you. Just we want to be very optimistic here. So please get in touch with as a class representative, and please ask your class representative to inform us at least before Wednesday or Thursday at least. Okay, by the way, just for our curiosity and for our improvement purpose only, are you okay with this kind of strategy which you are proceeding further? Just we like to hear from you. Of course, it is not exactly the way which we goes on the classroom sessions. At least around 40, 45 people are there now. We like to hear from you because you may be having a difficulty in understanding the topics, and of course, it is an initial, some teetering problems will be there for everybody. But still, we like to hear what is that you have some, if there are some issues, if we can rectify from our side, if you can rectify from your side. Because from your side, you'll say a lot of things will be there. I agree that. So, but nevertheless, at least in 1 week, we accept 4 to 5 students. They are able to complete those quiz exercises. Means, yes, they're able to access those things. And means the material is able to be accessed and you are trying to proceed further. Yes, is a good sign only, is a positive sign from all of you. And definitely we'll try to put more some kind of what do you call, we'll make our presentations also a little bit more attractive also. We'll see, slowly we'll see. So because the first 2 weeks is basically the network, means the network concepts are there, which is basically an application layer protocol. So not much practice on, but still, please do practice on FTP, SSH, your HTTP. These three are very, very important, please. Email is not that much important, but at least let me just share something here. Nowadays, everybody is working from home. Work from home, that is the concept which is going on, even for the software industry and all. You know how this work from home concept has been means very much fruitful now, because the most important protocols, your SSH, your FTP. So those SSH and FTP and your HTTP protocols, they're able to run from their home laptops. Of course, there are other protocols too, but because these protocols were running successfully, people are able to sit in the home and trying to execute the programs which are to be executed on the server. So even our Moodle servers were installed like that and we are maintaining like this. That is one live example for you all. So you have to get practice on clear understanding about SSH, FTP, HTTP. So please get into practice of the minimum things from the first unit, the practice of SSH, FTP, and HTTP. That will definitely gain you a lot of confidence. You can also connect to different remote servers. Yeah, somebody is asking. There are a bit more unknown questions in the quizzes which were not taught. This was what I felt the quizzes I attempted. Okay. Yeah, I agree. It is not very to a large extent. Means out of 10 questions, definitely 2-3 questions will be there. It's not not all 8 to 10 questions. So definitely it will be there, 2 to 3 questions. Why we give it to you in the sense that when we give some references to your we are given reference to your textbook. We are giving the audio-video reference to the end of our slides. So you need to explore this, all these things. And please listen to the audios properly. You will definitely, I can assure you, 90 to 95% will be there. The question will be there in the quizzes itself. So one or two questions in each quiz, definitely there will be, it's not that out of scope. We want you to explore more here. So that is the reason which we give sometimes one or two questions out of the scope or a little bit somewhat, it's not confusing, but because the way we try to you to make you to understand, some questions will be framed like that. So your thinking concepts will be in that particular direction. That's the reason why we give one or two questions to have a little bit of thought process to be involved there in some kind of direction which you like to have it. That is the reason for the unknown. It is not a direct questions, never don't expect. So there will be problems also, which we, if you might have seen in the Q's 6 and Q's 5, I have changed the, means if you understand the concept properly, you'll be able to solve the problems. and your inferences also should be very much clarity. So it is not just to make you to have less marks and all. Of course, if you see here, people are able to get 10 out of 10 in most of the cases. 9.17. If you make more attempts, obviously. One more important point I'd like to share with you. I forgot to tell you in the last week. See, when I observed here on the number of attempts you are making, when the number of attempts, usually there are out of, this is a class for 82. So when I say 82, how come thousands of attempts can come? And thousands of attempts means a person is repeatedly opening the question. When a person is, you know, we have the log here, how many times you're opening the question and how many times you're seeing that question and all. See, around 2000 times the quiz one has been made an attempt for a pupil of around 70 plus students. 2000 times means it can be derived that you are opening the question several times means you are referring to that question on the Google again, maybe Google or some other sources, and you are again coming back, or you are referring to your book or to the video and you are coming back. There may be so many other reasons maybe there to make an attempt of that question. So don't go in that direction, please. That is not a good habit of practice. The purpose of that quiz is to make yourself to have some confidence in you, how much you are able to understand from that, the video lesson and from the PDFs and from the other materials that we are giving to you. Once you complete reading that, only you have to come to your quizzes, please. So without completely understanding or without completely reading that, you please don't make an attempt in the quizzes. You can directly go with the quiz, and based on the quiz question, if you are referring to the slide or if you are referring to other sources from the internet or if you're referring to the video lessons, that is not the don't go in that reverse direction. Actually, we want to give specific times, but because see, we cannot put those restrictions here. We can keep the restrictions that it is capable to keep restrictions. But we don't know when the student is able to make an attempt for a different set of students. So I suggest you all, please, first you wholeheartedly, you first listen to video lessons, read the material. Again, if you want, you can read, listen to the video lesson once again. Again, read the materials. So once you are confident, then only make an quiz attempts. Otherwise, quiz one is around 2096 times it has been made an attempt for 70 students. It means each student, at least there are 10 questions in that. Usually it should go to 700 or at least some 1000. It is a double than that means, double times means you are referring, you are moving forward and backward. Just you are making yourself to get that answer from different sources. So that habit, please try to avoid it in the beginning only. I hope you understand what I am trying to say here. Okay. So for the lab practicals, please keep ready your you need one editor and one browser for the first 2 weeks, please. The editor can be anything, Notepad or simply Notepad++, or Visual Studio Code Editor or your Atom. And one browser. So browser, JavaScript enabled browser, please. So your JavaScript enabled option will be there on your browser. And one more thing, you can use Google Chrome, is preferable, or Mozilla Firefox. If you have Internet Explorer, that is also acceptable. But the only thing is, please check this option which I'm showing now on the screen. All of you, any browser, this option should be there for you. Just keep an eye on my screen, please. All of you.
You are not sharing the screen. Oh, okay.
So I'm just showing from this Google Chrome. See, on the Google Chrome, you can see there are three vertical dots on the right side corner. You click that one, and you can see more tools here. And under that, you can see developer tools. So on the Internet Explorer, you'll see it on the options. There will be options. Under that options, you'll see developer tools. Similarly, when you click the developer option, developer tools, you'll get this small window here, which shows us the elements, console, sources. Like this, whatever you type it and whatever you write the programs here, like something like this, which I've shown you in the video. Those who have seen the video is okay. But those are not seen, so you can see here. Once I open a particular website, all that elements, you can see here, this corresponding information you get it. Actually, what pages, what, how much time it is taken, what protocol, what is the status. So once again, I'm just refreshing this one. You can see it on my right side of your developer screen. See, some data is coming for you. A web developer always keeps looking to these kinds of things. Something like your troubleshooting purpose, and something like tracking what if there is some error, something is not coming, or something is fishy things are happening here. Whether you, what is expected on your web page is not shown, you can something like trace back. So this particular tool, developer tools, is going to be very much useful for you. So like this, you can see actually the images. What is the name? What is the file name they have given the, on the server? Everything can be seen here. And you cannot hack also, of course. These things will be there. So this, what I mean to say is developer tools, this particular option should be there on your web browsers. This will not be there on the old browsers. So if you are not having on the old browser, you need to get updated your browser. When you upgrade your browser, this developer tools option will be there. Once again, I show you where is this developer tools. You can go to your browser, open any page or just a blank page, more tools, developer tools. Click the developer tools. It will, you can dock it onto the right side, or you can just bring this back to a separate window. It's up to you. If it is not there, please upgrade your browsers. So this will help us a lot in understanding our programming purpose. It will something like debugging your program. When you write your script, you can debug and you can see if, what is exactly happening. If some logic is wrong, that can be easily corrected here. So you need to get into practice of using these developer tools. Just keep this ready from Wednesday and Thursday onwards. But the unit 2 will officially will start it on the Monday. But we, some material we post it onto the next week. By the next weekend, we'll post the materials which are related to the unit 2. So you need to keep ready of all those things, please, so that you can be online with the practice.
Okay, I have one very important announcement to make to you all. Okay, also tell this to your friends as well. One week ago, one of the students actually said like people have difficulties attending the lecture from 6 to 8, isn't it? So we had put a request to the institute to push it from 4 to 6. Okay, and it seems like just now it has been approved. So from next Monday onwards, we will have our sessions from 4 to 6 p.m. Remember this, not anymore from 6 to 8 p.m., but from 4 to 6 p.m. And we are changing this based on requests from your own friends. All of you agree? No response? So all of you prefer 6 to 8 p.m.? 4 to 6 p.m. on Monday, DBMS class? No, you should not be having that. Rupesh? I'm a little bit confused because as far as the timetable is concerned, it should not be there. Okay, right. Probably for the beginning or something. Because now, as far as the schedule and timetable is concerned, internet technologies is from 4 to 6 p.m. Okay, it is an official schedule from the School of Computer Science and Information Sciences. If anything else is clashing, you have to inform the respective professor. Okay? That you have session from 4 to 6, internet technology session.
Yeah, if you have any doubts, please put forward the questions, please.
Yeah, we are still online to answer any questions if you have.
Hello, Arun, are you able to solve your problem of installing that bind? Arun, I hope you are online. Oh no. Okay, so still that's Microsoft runtime library is not installed. Are you able to? Yeah, I have installed Visual Studio 2007 edition, but it still gives me the same error. Visual Studio 2017, yeah, it already includes the runtime library. But anyway, because today I have given you one possible solution for having Unix. So I hope you have listened to that using the virtual machine. Yes, you have decided to go with virtual. Very good. So this virtual machine will definitely be helpful for you for in a longer run. So you can play with that. And when it will not do any harm to your the physical hardware. So if you need something goes wrong, it will just simply crash. You can get it back. So do practice on the Ubuntu operating system. So that's what I was telling to you all. Prefer for Ubuntu at least a Linux operating system. Initially, difficult will be there in getting on with the commands because everything you need to work it on the commands. But Ubuntu GUI is also there for you. Ubuntu operating system comes with GUI, so it will be easy for you. Yeah. Because when you are working on Windows, there may be multiple reasons there which you need to be sorted out one after the other. Subramaniam, yeah, if you can tell me exactly what, if you mention the topic that we have to read from the textbook, it will be a lot better. So for the first unit, whatever the topics we have given you in the slides, so whatever the topics, if you see here, once again, please can you, I'll just share my screen, hold on. So if you see the first week topics, this is week one. So this week one, basically unit one is on application layer protocols. This entire application layer protocols, I told you clearly in the introduction that we are referring to one book. That book is basically your open source book. And the slides, whatever the slides, if you see here, all the material slides, around 80 to 90% of the slides. Of course, for you to understand, I may add some new figures. These figures may not be seen in the textbook, but it's for your understanding only. I write some important points and the figures here. But if you see, these are all the diagrams which is taken from the same textbook only. I have not done anything. You have to, the same procedures are there from the same textbook. So all this is basically these slides, whatever this slide is in from the same textbook, that is a chapter number 3. So this is the textbook. Under this textbook, you have application layer protocol as one chapter. So everything that you see here, if you closely observe all this, even the domain names, all this, this particular thing is also from the same textbook. For you to understand, I may draw some new figures. This is, I have drawn it. You will not find it in any textbook here for you to understand. But this text, how to uniquely distribute domain names, this is from the textbook only. These are the slides from the textbook, in fact. All these diagrams are from the same textbook chapter. For you to understand, I have drawn this diagram, and you can see some of those things. but the explanation is from the same textbook only. Similarly, if you see all this, even distributed the latest topic, for you to understand what is hash table, I have given one or two examples here. What is meant by hashing? How hashing can be done here? These are some of the slides which I prepared from my own. It's not from another textbook. You can ask now the doubts if you cannot understand these things. So that will be useful for you. And if you see this, all these examples, these are some which I prepared, and some other slides, you can see this, the same diagram, you see it on the same textbook chapter only. And this is a continuation of what the example I'm given here. These are all from the same reference textbook, the chapter unit one is completely from the same chapter. It's not some other sources we have taken any material. You have to read thoroughly the line. We will not see, give you line to line. This line is taken from the textbook. So even HTTP, get post methods, all these topics are from the same textbook. This diagram is from the same textbook itself. I have not added even this same diagram, this also. These steps are also from the same textbook. You can see this is, that's why in the beginning of our slides, we mentioned that we have taken from this so-and-so and the slides and the materials from this computer networking principles, protocols, practice. And I have shown you the link also how to download that particular book I have told you in the last interactive session. So please refer to the same book only. We are not referring to multiple sources too. There was something like entire architecture in Qzone. So yes, that's what I told you. You see, what is a client server? A client server is a two-tier architecture. Okay, so the client server is a two-tier architecture, and why it is two-tier? Here, if you look to the diagram, and again, I'm coming back to this. What does that N indicate? Small N indicates the number of levels, the number of layers. So if you look to my video lesson, please listen to this video lesson properly. I have given a three-tier also there. The word three-tier is also there in this video lesson when I'm discussing the client-server model. So of course, the three-tier, where is the, how the three-tier has come then? What is three-tier here? If you see the material, in the material and then in the video, when I'm discussing, I told you clearly, if this server is a web server and your database server is some other place, then it is called as basically a three-tier. So one tier means first level is client, second level is web server, the third level is database. And if you keep on increasing the more servers here, it becomes an entire. N indicates the number of levels, the number of servers in between you are using for your web applications to traverse, or for your web application to retrieve and store your data. So when you have more tiers, then definitely more levels are there. So client server, you have to generalize that. That meaning you get it from the textbook itself. That textbook also has got the three-tier, the word name three-tier. So that one or two questions you need to infer. You have to get back to your thought process. That's what I told you. Thought process means how do you think about it? So if you start teaching what is entire now, that itself will go about another class. So it is just an, you need to be aware of what can be N indicates. So client server model is a two-tier. Client server model with an additional database server, it becomes a three-tier. And if you have another web services in another level, it becomes a four-tier. So if you keep on increasing the number of levels, it becomes an entire. You can ask this kind of questions in the interactive sessions. That is almost very good. Welcome to you all. So we can explain to you that these things, yes. Yeah, Subramanian, I hope you got the point to understand. Are you there? So are you clear with the explanation, Subramanya?
Yeah, he is saying yes. It's okay.
Yeah.
So in summary, the point is like, okay, so you have to listen to the videos, okay, you have to read through the book chapter, and you also have to explore a little bit, okay, for additional answers. So that's why we are not fixing like you have to answer that question in a minute or something. We have not restricted in quizzes. So if something is not clear, go explore.
These interactive sessions are meant for that only. Immediately, you need not answer it. If you just read the material once or twice, see the video at least minimum at least once properly. Still, if you cannot get it twice, you please listen. If both of them are not possible, you can put forward the question in the interactive or through email. So definitely, we will get back to you. So there are ways are there for that. Only thing is, yes, you need to. It is not that immediately, readily you have to get that answer. We don't expect that those things immediately to answer for you. So those quizzes are meant for you to try to you are the way you think and the way you understood the topic and the way you are trying to answer it. So these kind of questions, usually if there is a classroom, we can pose those questions directly in the classroom. But what happens is this is a thing which you cannot go it. So that's why we kept those kind of questions in the quizzes, that your awareness and your knowledge base will be increased. Please do remember, this internet technologies is what the latest developments are so much enormous. Every day, latest development is happening across the web. Because today you have electronic gadgets which are affordable to you, means your mobile phones are there with you, electronic devices, hardware costs are coming, have come down a lot. So this is all, every day you need to get updated. Otherwise, yourself will be very obsolete very soon. So your mind should be, this is one of the course that requires a lot of updations every day, please. Every day. So you need to be very much patient in going the things very much quickly. So don't think that just simply writing a program will make you to understand. This technology, technique, new methods. And you have to come out with new exercises too. So we will give some case study exercise at least after some 4 or 5 weeks are over, then we will give some case study exercises. Then you can just go through it accordingly.